Bloody hell. Seemed like that thing wanted to grab my head. shit. Right, something really heavy just crashed on the floor.
Everywhere. Thank you. Holy shit. What the hell is that? Huh?
Thank you.
smashing. It seems the statuette was hiding something.
Oh, bloody hell. How could I be so stupid?
Yes, they do. Saw at Hush's place. If he's anywhere to be found. Has to be in here. It's time to put an end to this nightmare. Thank you. hell is happening? Oh, God. Mr. Husha? Shit. Oh, shit. Mr. Husha! Oh, no. Sebastian! Oh, shit. Fuck. Oh, he's dead. Fuck, man. Fuck! This is the same place. The same room. What's happening? Hello! Diary. I'll go to the Grand. Damn it, another... things. Oh shit, Dan. Wake the fuck up, man. Am I? Oh, thank God.
Daniel, are you all right?
I'm alive, at least.
Oh, Daniel.
Don't worry. Let's get out of here.
Oh, Mr. Neuer, are you all right? Did you find Sebastian?
Mr. Finnegan, I... Sebastian is dead.
What? Oh, my God! How?
I'm sorry. I... Shit. Let's get out of here, please. I don't have much time.
Sebastian. Wait. What do you mean you don't have much time? He said the same thing on his way here. And I... Jesus. If only I'd paid more attention. If only I'd done something.
I don't think there's anything you could have done, really.
Maybe. But maybe I can do something for you.
Thanks. All I need right now is to get out of here.
On our way, then.
Husha died in there, trapped. He probably struggled and screamed until he went mad trying to find a way out of that godforsaken place. Like me, only, in his case, nobody got there in time. I imagine he thought that there was a quicker way to go. The same way that Faber chose. And maybe I would have done the same in his place. What I saw myself do in that mirror was just too much. Is this what lies ahead? Maybe I already know it, but I'm trying to hide it from myself. Maybe deep down, I know it's a hideous omen of what the future has in store for me. Maybe I know that, like everyone who's come across that cursed box, I too will take my own life. That I would rather surrender to death than face whatever it is that lingers behind that infernal melody. I should burn the thing. Make that melody vanish from the face of the earth. But what about Ariadne? She's alive. What if only the box can stop this? I can't destroy it without knowing for sure. Maybe there's something in Legrand's diary. Oh God, I need to rest and gather my thoughts. I need to sleep. I can only hope the nightmares won't be as horrible as real life. I need... Husha died in there, trapped. He probably struggled and screamed until he went mad trying to find a way out of that godforsaken place. Like me, only, in his case, nobody got there in time. I imagine he thought that there was a quicker way to go, the same way that Faber chose, and maybe I would have done the same in his place. What I saw myself do in that mirror was just too much. Is this what lies ahead? Maybe I already know it, but I'm trying to hide it from myself. Maybe deep down, I know it's a hideous omen of what the future has in store for me. Maybe I know that, like everyone who's come across that cursed box, I too will take my own life. That I would rather surrender to death than face whatever it is that lingers behind that infernal melody. I should burn the thing. Make that melody vanish from the face of the earth. But what about Ariadne? She's alive. What if only the box can stop this? I can't destroy it without knowing for sure. Maybe there's something in Legrand's diary. Oh God, I need to rest and gather my thoughts. I need to sleep. I can only hope the nightmares won't be as horrible as real life. I need...
What? Melody. God. I need to find something. There must be something here. Farber, Husher, every single person who attended that cursed concert in the Abbey, the entire LeGrand Amersburg family and I, we all heard the song. Argos LeGrand's diary, which I found in that place beyond reality, was my only hope of unveiling something, anything, that could take me down a different path than the rest. And yet, LeGrand's notes seemed like nothing more than erratic and incoherent ramblings of a broken mind, so demented that no one could put them together in any order, much less understand them. But I found something towards the end that made some kind of sense. Although, I wish I hadn't.
It's all over. Just a moment ago, I... like every night, the song was invading my dreams, grating incessantly. I woke up, soaked in sweat, and veiled by the shadows. Natalie was sleeping, but I was not. This time, it had to stop. I was hell-bent on destroying the source of that awful song. I went down to the basement and tore down the same wall I built myself. With each blow, I cursed the moment I decided to bring that melody into my home. I couldn't take it any longer. There she was, behind the wall. My wife, huddled in a corner, holding Elaine in her arms. I froze. If Natalie was there, what kind of diabolical creature was sleeping by my side? Monsters. All of them. My beloved Elaine, Natalie. The monsters had locked them away and wanted to take Ariadne. They wanted to take my baby. I grasped the mallet, determined to do whatever it took. I would not allow those fiends to take my daughter, not without a fight. They would rue the day they tried to harm my family. I would kill the monsters and the black figure and find my little girl. I followed them throughout the house. Every room was shrouded in darkness. There was something unnatural in the air. The melody had transformed into a choir of black curling howls. But I finally cornered them in the bedroom, where I finished them off. I drew blood, and it flowed like a well from the grotesque black figures while they screamed and writhed, the vile, deceitful fiends. And then I went back to the basement, and there was nobody there. Natalie and Elaine had disappeared. No. That isn't true. They had not disappeared. They had never been down there. They were upstairs, in the bedroom where I had left them. There were no monsters in the house. Except me. Only me. Only me. And the presence.
Oh my God. It ends like this? Wait, what is this? Jeremy Hartwood Mental Hospital, 1920. Psychiatric analysis and treatment of patient Ariadne LeGrand Amsberg. Dr. Berenice Prestigard. Oh, Christ, I can barely stand up. I really need help with this.
place is in a shambles. Wonder what I'll find here. Is that a power generator? Okay, I need to find information regarding Ariadne or her psychiatrist, Dr. Prestigard.